Good evening, Rowan. It's the 2nd of August 2018 and it's about 11:45. And obviously this is my usual Friday evening video being recorded once again on Thursday to reassure you that I won't be seducing any priests over the weekend. I won't be hanging around the Catholic parish of St Urban's hoping to bump into any pretend astrophysicists in order to save your skin. And I won't be coming out as a lesbian either, in order to save your gigantic ego. So everything is exactly the same as usual. Nothing ever changes. Anyway, I thought we could continue our perusal of the dialogue that you were in on the 5th of July 2018. So I don't want to say too much about it because I've put together an extensive video commentary. The details of the dialogue will be on the screen shortly. Just to say that you're talking about a specific exhibition at Kettle's Yard in Cambridge, and there are some of the exhibits in the exhibition up on the screen. That's the exhibition that you're talking about in the clip that I'm dealing with in this video. There's just two things I want to say about the things that you say allegedly in relation to this exhibition. First of all, there is nothing unique about mummies, boys. When you've seen one, you've seen them all. So that's the first thing. And the second thing is that you're not called to do anything along with me. So zip your trousers up and fuck off. And there's going to be no relationship between us. There's never been any relationship between us. It's all in your head. And you are not getting along with me in any way whatsoever. I'm not interested in having anything to do with you at all. And you're not going to force that on me by inflicting me or afflicting me with all this bullshit and harassment and abuse and tipping decades of my life down the drain. So get that through your head and move on, mummy's boy. And in any case, I'm saving myself for my beloved because he's so wonderful and we're made for each other and we just can't wait to be together on our bed of roses, on our silk sheets, having a really good time in each other's arms, resisting tyrannous authorities. And of course, your wife will be doing exactly the same with her hot, sexy Rastafarian boyfriend the moment that you're out of the picture. If she's not doing that already, I mean. So, that's the end of my video for today. The video commentary on this section of the dialogue is coming up now. But just to remind you to be alert because I will be turning up to make a citizen's arrest for terrorism and also to ask you those awkward questions that I've still got up my sleeve. Hasta la próxima.
Let's find out what Rowan thinks of it haptically, theologically, poetically, phenomenologically. And then some.
Anything else?
Yes. Anything else you can try and
imagine. So no pressure.
How is it for you? Yes.
It's exactly that unsettlement of the space.
Wagon, tent, or trail upon last week, last year, or in far off days. Born here or a thousand miles away, there's always men nearby who say,
you'd better get born in some place else. So move along, get along, move along, get along, go. Move, shift.
Give me life, give me action. At the touch of a button. Flying through hyperspace. In a computer interface.
It's exactly that unsettlement the space, which is so immediate when you go into Kettle's Yard. Kettle's Yard, which is itself, of course, a unique space, isn't it? And
Ground control to Major Tom, your circuit's dead. There's something wrong, can you hear me, Major Tom?
Kettle's Yard, which is itself, of course, a unique space, isn't it?
Wonderful.
And a place which is in and not of.
Yeah.
But I think because of the way in which the steel rods run out of the space you sort of thought they were in, or your imagination instinctively contains them.
Bong, bong, hey, pour me a beer. No pretty drinks, I'm a gay out here. Rolling, 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 rolling money like a pimp. My B-I-T-C-H is on my dick like this.
But I think because of the way in which the steel rods run out of the space you sort of thought they were in, or your imagination instinctively contains them. And they're not actually contained. That's one of the things. They run across, connecting different spaces. Run across, connecting different spaces. And also, as you walk around, your sense of the angle of these rods, the angles open or close.
I don't like if you love me, love me, love me. I'll drive you crazy. Dream, dream, dream when I feel blue in the night and I need. Hold me tight whenever I want you. All I have to do is dream.
The angles open or close. They don't, again, like the other things we've been talking about, they don't sit still. You are collaborating in the making of an intelligible space all the time.
I'm a rocket ship on my way to Mars on a collision course.
You are collaborating in the making of an intelligible space all the time. And the human figures within these unsettling spaces have a similar sort of unsettling effect. And when I say unsettling, I don't mean disturbing or distressing. I mean...
The wise men came so stern and strict and brought the order to evict. You'd better get born in some place else. So move along, get along, move along, get along, go. Move, shift.
And when I say unsettling, I don't mean disturbing or distressing. I mean the sort of churn that takes you out of routine perception, and with this very spare aesthetic, tells you certain things.
Levitation, I suppose.
Well, my thought about that actually was, pretentiousness alert. pretentiousness alert. Kierkegaard talking about the human being suspended over 70,000 fathoms or whatever. I thought, well, if I were lying there, I wouldn't know whether it was 6 inches or 70,000 fathoms underneath me. I thought, well, if I were lying there, I wouldn't know whether it was 6 inches or 70,000 fathoms underneath me. But we're poised somewhere in that potentially meaningful void, which here we're invited to make sense of and contemplate and sit with. Invited to make sense of and contemplate and sit with. In a way, it's about grasping something of contingency, createdness, and the immense liberty of...
I know what you're thinking, baby, and if I was to tell you, you'd think I was talking in centimetres.
Thank you.
having something of contingency, createdness, and the immense liberty of understanding, shaping, reflecting the space that's around us.
Discovering something brand new. Well, I'm in love with your body. I'm in love with your body. I'm in love with your body.
I control all your thoughts and all your moves. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati.
Ground control to Major Tom, your circuit's dead. There's something wrong, can you hear me, Major Tom?
Understanding, shaping, reflecting the space that's around us. I'm not putting that very well, but I found these obscurely very moving images indeed because of that. Because of the frailty of every particular place you stand, and yet the real materiality and solidity of the whole thing. The real materiality and solidity of the whole thing. It's back to the homelessness, the homecoming and loss thing.
What care I for my house and land? What care I for my treasures, oh? What care I for my new wedded lord? I'm off with the raggle-taggle gypsies, oh.
The homelessness, the homecoming and loss thing, the fragility and solidity, so much to do with the central paradoxes of our human experience.
And the devil in a black dress watches, oh. My guardian angel walks away. Life is short and love is always over in the morning. Black wind, come carry me far away.
So much to do with the central paradoxes of our human experience, which, again, as a religious believer.
I control all your thoughts and all your moves. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati.
As a religious believer, has deep echoes for me.
I know what you're thinking, baby, and if I was to tell you, you'd think I was talking in centimetres.
This time I rock this one, I'm up on the whole goddamn chicken side. I thought I even put my tip in that hole yet. I'm about to get in and try and rip it wider.
Again, as a religious believer, has deep echoes for me. I'm not just something fixed, plugged into a space. I'm not a given.
Give me life, give me action. At the touch of a button. Flying through hyperspace. In a computer interface.
Give it to me, baby, like boom, boom, boom.
I'm not just something fixed, plugged into a space. I'm not a given. I'm summoned always to be making sense along with, making sense of space, making sense of matter. And when I'm most distant from what I think of as myself, I'm often most clearly on the way to some sort of home. But I won't rabbit on. It's just that those spaces are intensely evocative and powerful to me.
There's nothing left to try. There's no greater power than the power of goodbye.
Late night. hands. She's got both hands.
And late that night when the Lord came home, inquiring of his lady, oh. The servant said on every hand, she's gone with the raggle-tackle gypsies, oh.
The footman memorized the number, but the prince still holds both the slippers. And would you leave a premise for a bedsit and Canterbury tales?
Sex.
Oh, what care I for my house and my land? What care I for my money? Oh, I'd rather have a kiss from the wild gypsy's lips. I'm away with the raggle-taggle gypsy.
With the raggle-taggle gypsy.
I'm away with the raggle-taggle gypsy.